Today I'm going to show you how to very quickly and easily slice your photos to do this. Divide them evenly so to create seamless transition from left of the photo to the right, which is pretty cool for Instagram if you're into that stuff. And I'll throw in some bonus explanations of how to convert one or two or all of the components into video or GIFs if that's what you're interested in doing. Right, here's the photo we want to split and we have it opened up in Lightroom. This one I want to slice in two. So I want two adjacent photos that have a crop ratio of 4:5 for a total crop of 8:5. I'll explain in a bit. Let's edit this in Photoshop. First off, the crop. Using Instagram preferences as an example crop, we know that the supposedly optimal aspect is 4:5. I don't care much for that and post the ratio that the photo calls for, but to entertain this tutorial, let's do 4:5. Our minimum resolution is ideally 1080 pixels. So for an aspect of 4:5, we can set our resolutions to 1080x1350. To do this twice for scrolling, it's 2160x1350, and to have three slices, you can assign a crop of 3240x1350. Mine's two slices, so we'll go for the 2160x1350. Hit C for the crop tool, or you can find it here like so. You can define your parameters up here, 8:5. And let's set our image area. Once we're cropped, navigate to view and select new guide layout. Make sure columns is checked and that width and gutter are set to 0 and that the number matches your slice number. For us, it's 2. All right. Select your slice tool and hit slices from guide. Now we want to set our image size so that we are getting the most from our crop. Navigate to image and to image size. Make sure your dimensions are linked and set your width to 2160 as we discussed. You'll see it'll set the height to 1350 to adhere with the 8:5 crop factor. Now to export our two images, navigate to File, Export, Save for Web. Set your export preferences and make sure that the photo is recognized as a JPEG. If you encounter problems with mixed or unexpected exports with this step, for example, if you end up with a GIF or pings instead of JPEGs, check out our video on that export topic linked above right now and linked in the description down below. But to briefly hit that topic, in short, select your slice tool here and use it to select both images and mark them as JPEGs. Hit save and select your save location. With multiple slices, Photoshop will create a folder called images within that designated location, and you'll find your images in there. And when you're finally uploading, make sure you expand each photo to reveal its entire aspect. Now, if you wish to incorporate video, follow all the steps up until export. And let's just take this composition, for example. Open a sequence in Premiere Pro that matches a single slice. In our case, it's 1080x1350, and import your relevant image. And all I did was I added my video, in this case it was a GIF, and exported that sequence as a 1080x1350 video. And I uploaded that as the slice instead of the photo. And that's pretty much it. If you found that you learned something, if you found this was useful, interesting, entertaining, feel free to give the video a thumbs up, share, subscribe, all that good stuff. As always, thank you so much for watching and I'll catch you in the next video.